Now, in a shift in policy, Facebook is to ban praise, support and representation of white nationalism and white separatism on its social media platforms, bolstering its efforts to tackle hate speech. The policy will be enforced next week on Facebook as well as Instagram. Now, this comes after criticism by civil rights groups that the social media giant is failing to confront extremism. Speaking today in Christchurch, the Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern reiterated the need for the tech sector to do its part in stopping the spread of hate and violence.
In the wake of the terrorist attack here, there is much work to do. You will have seen the reports overnight that Facebook has taken steps to extend its application of hate speech to prohibit the promotion and support of white nationalism and white separatism. Arguably, these categories should always have fallen within the community guidelines of hate speech. But nevertheless, it's positive the clarification has now been made in the wake of the attack here in Christchurch. I also note that the Australian government is looking to introduce legislation that would impose penalties on social media companies if they do not restrain the spread of extremist material. Ireland, Germany and others have also looked to put in place measures to address harmful content, which reflects the broader international community's view that more needs to be done to resolve the problem we face while preserving a free, open, and secure internet. I do believe that New Zealand has a role to play in this debate and in much needed reform. I'm focused on working collaboratively to find meaningful solutions. Ultimately, we can all promote good rules locally, but these platforms are global, and I believe, therefore, the solutions will need to be too.
Kristen Clark is the president of the Lawyers Committee for Civil Rights in Washington, which has been pushing Facebook for months to take a harder line against hate. She says the massacre in Christchurch added further impetus for the social media giant to take action.
We have been engaging and pushing Facebook for reform for months. Our efforts date back to the late summer of 2018. So we know that this is something that we've been pushing for some time. I would expect that the tragedy that unfolded in New Zealand perhaps provided the extra push to get them to the finish line. We are still reeling from horrendous hate incidents that have unfolded at houses of worship here in the U.S., in Charleston, South Carolina, and Pittsburgh. And what happened in New Zealand was incredibly awful. It's time that the tech sector do its part to stand up to hate. So many of the violent white supremacists who are behind these tragic incidents resort to platforms online to organize, to recruit, to broadcast their hateful activity. It is our hope that other companies will follow Facebook's lead, and most certainly more must be done.
The video that the gunman posted went around the world like wildfire really quickly, so hard to rein in. Facebook's a big beast. Is this simply a virtue signalling move, or is it actually possible for them to take a stand here and actually put into effect what they say they're going to do?
They need more diversity around the table. And part of the reason why Facebook has maintained this broken policy is because they don't have experts on civil rights and hate crimes and racial justice who are working with them to think through these issues. And you're right, they are a beast. They are certainly with the resources and means to tackle these issues. So it's time for the public to really speak out and hold Facebook and other companies across the tech sector accountable.
Many groups have already complained to Facebook over the last few years about at least their perceptions that their points of view are being censored in some way. Are we confident that there's an agreed or a consensus around the definition of what actually is white supremacy? Is it different, or how is it different from white nationalism or separatism, as they're saying? There'll be people out there that have a point of view that Donald Trump's Make America Great Again is pure white nationalism. Should that be banned? We're getting into the political debate realm. This is pretty fraught, isn't it?
these are violent ideologies that are behind some of the ugliest and sometimes fatal hate incidents that we're seeing across the country and across the globe. This is a distinction without a difference that Facebook had maintained. There is no defensible way to justify drawing a distinction between white supremacy and white nationalism and white separatism. They are one in the same. This is an ideology embraced by neo-Nazis, by the alt-right, and people who have violent intentions directed against communities of color, communities of faith, and other vulnerable populations. It's time that Facebook stop giving them a platform that can be easily exploited to incite violence, recruit new individuals to their movement. And part of what we're doing here is telling Facebook that they have a role to play in standing up against the hate crime crisis that we face today. And we'll be policing Facebook's platform to make sure that they are indeed shutting out people who are abusing the platform to incite violence.
Who else are you approaching and calling on to follow suit?
Twitter, Reddit. I mean, all of these online platforms have a role to play. And so we are going to keep fighting and working to hold them accountable for the way in which they facilitate so much of the hateful activity that we're seeing across the globe today.
Kristen Clark there in Washington, D.C.